Kalashnikov automatic rifle, Avtomat Kalashnikova in Russian. Better known around the world as AK, its form and image are familiar to many. Yet very few are aware about the extent of possibilities for use in combat available through specialized training and what well-trained professional is capable of with this very simple, reliable and effective weapon. Conceived a specialized weapon for professionals within special purpose units, AK became standard issue assault rifle for Soviet and later Russian armed forces. But its full potential as a weapon, not just a firearm, was explored and put to use only by a very limited number of professionals in the most elite entities of Soviet Russian Special Forces, Spetsnaz. Beyond the firearm, AK-4774 in CQB instructional video exposes for the first time some of the methods and principles of work with Kalashnikov rifle. Familiarization with the weapon, understanding its basic functions, methods of carry and rapid deployment for combat, movement in hostile engagement conditions, its effective use in hand-to-hand combat against armed or unarmed adversaries, and other topics are covered in this video. In-depth knowledge and understanding of these and some other specialized skills and training methods, that's what makes Avtomat Kalashnikova in the hands of trained specialists into extremely effective, reliable and multifunctional combat tool that goes beyond the firearm. New generation of Soviet small arms emerged from the mine and design bureau of Mikhail Timofeyevich Kalashnikov. His creative work resulted in emergence of one of the most reliable and functional families of modern firearms. Mikhail Kalashnikov was born November 10, 1919 in Altai territory in Russia. After combat injury received in late 1941, Mikhail Kalashnikov dedicated his talent to creation of new generation of military assault rifles. After a few test submachine gun models conceived and produced from 1941 through 1946, final design of Avtomat Kalashnikova AK-47 was developed in 1946 and adopted by Soviet Armed Forces in 1949. It was followed by AKM, modernized Kalashnikov automatic rifle, in 1959, with improved functionality and considerably reduced weight. These rifles, as well as RPK light machine gun, were based on 7.62x39 caliber cartridge. AK-47, AKM, AKMS and RPK were produced in unmatched quantity with variety of modifications in a number of countries around the world. In the mid-70s came next step in the evolution of AK family of weapons, and it was based on new 5.45x39 caliber cartridge.
5.45x39 round used by AK-74 is a significant improvement over 5.56x45 NATO round used by M16, M4, AR-15 family of weapons and many other Western designs. In large part, improvement is due to the 5mm air pocket in the tip of the bullet. With hardened steel penetrator used in 7N6, 7N22 armor-piercing rounds and number of enhanced penetration rounds alongside with regular full metal jacket ammunition, 5.45x39 caliber ammunition for AK-74 family of weapons has well-rounded presentation for most possible uses in modern close-quarters combat.
New AK-74 family of weapons emerged with significant variety of Kalashnikov automatic rifles, specifically designed for more specialized use in various environments. Number of additional accessories, grenade launchers, optical devices for precision and nighttime use, silencers were developed with possibility of retrofitting older AK-47 family weapons. From RPK-74 light machine gun to variety of shorter barrel specialized weapons, including handgun caliber cartridge-based submachine guns, were developed to address new realities of modern warfare. With new revolutionary designs in Russian small arms emerging, Kalashnikov weapons still remain the most commonly used personal firearms.
Автомат Калашникова has proven its combat efficiency and reliability throughout a number of years. While many other fine military weapons of more recent design have more advanced ergonomics, are lighter and marginally more accurate for aimed firing at longer distances, AK family of rifles remains unmatched in overall efficiency in combat while considering toughness, simplicity of operation and field repairs, adaptability for various environments of combat and reliability under extreme conditions. AK in its design is a relatively simple weapon, yet for those who may have to use it in combat, it is important to have intimate knowledge of its functions and features.
Автомат Калашникова has traditional assault rifle architecture. Its barrel at the tip houses front sight post, the bottom portion of which serves as a fixation device for cleaning rod positioned under the barrel. Front sight post is of open design and allows for easy bendage adjustment. Further down the body of the barrel we find gas cylinder. Upper hand guard with cylinder tube is located between the gas cylinder and rear sight base. Cleaning rod is located under the barrel and takes use of bayonet lug located at the bottom part of the gas cylinder assembly for fixation. Main body of Автомат Калашникова, which houses the internal mechanisms, consists of receiver with pistol grip, trigger group with guard, magazine release catch, safety selector catch, protruding operating handle, receiver cover, and rear sight base. Magazine release catch protrudes little below trigger guard level at the front, which makes magazine release and change very easy and intuitive, even under extreme stress of combat. The back end of the main body of AK houses pistol grip and variety of fixed or folding stocks. Protruding serrated catch at the rear of stamped receiver cover allows for easy removal of the cover. On the side of rear sight base we find gas cylinder tube lock lever and on top rear sight assembly. The underside of the receiver has opening for the magazine. It accepts standard AK magazine, curved 30-round staggered magazine made of metal, plastic or polymer, as well as a variety of higher capacity curved drum or box magazines used by RPK light machine gun. To remove the magazine, press forward on magazine release catch with your thumb while tilting magazine forward and pulling it down. To insert the magazine, place the lip located at the top of front side of the magazine into forward part of the opening and press the magazine body back and up until magazine release catch snaps, indicating proper placement. To disengage safety, pull safety catch lever down. For selective fire AKs, position all the way down activates single shot mode and middle position full auto mode. Charging the round in or ejecting one is done by pulling operating handle all the way back and releasing it. Located on the side of a rear sight base is gas cylinder tube lock lever. To release gas cylinder, pull the lever up and to lock it back, push it down until it snaps in place. Rear sight assembly allows for elevation adjustment by sliding up or down, setting it anywhere between 0 to 1000 meters. Markings are in 100 meter increments. First step in disassembly is removal of the magazine. Release safety lever catch, pull operating handle back to eject any round that may be in the weapon. Visually inspect to assure that weapon is safe, then release operating handle and depress the trigger. Press down on protruding serrated catch to remove receiver cover. Push the recoil spring guide forward so that the rear bottom lug section of the guide clears the dovetail slot at the rear of the receiver. remove recoil spring. To remove bolt carrier, piston and bolt as unit, pull them back to cutout section in receiver track and lift upward and rearward. To remove bolt from the bolt carrier, turn its head so that the guide lug aligns with the cam surface of the carrier. Rotate the bolt so that the guide lug leaves the camway of the bolt carrier and pull the bolt forward and out. Rotate the handguard lock lever on the rear side base upward and lift the handguard piston tube assembly.
In Soviet military, soldiers were required to practice disassembling and assembling their AKs and had time limits set that had to be met. Sometimes professionals took that further and did it blindfolded.
When the trigger is pressed, the siren disconnector rotates and raises the end of the hammer and trigger spring. The hammer rotates forward and strikes the rear of the firing pin, pushing it forward so that it strikes primer of the cartridge. Cartridge fires and gases flow through the gas port in the barrel into the gas cylinder and force the piston and bolt carry assembly to the rear, thus compressing recoil spring. Bolt rotates to the left and thereby unlocks. Bolt and carrier move back, rotating hammer to the rear and compressing hammer and trigger spring. Bolt moving to the rear, the extractor pulls cartridge case from the chamber and ejects it. Top round in the magazine is forced into chamber by following forward movement of the bolt carrier and bolt, which is caused by the compression of the recoil spring. As bolt approaches barrel face, it locks. The next round is fired by releasing the trigger and then pressing it again. Assembly follows reverse pattern of disassembly. Place handguard piston tube assembly between gas cylinder and rear sight assembly base. Push lock lever down to secure it. Place bolt into bolt carrier and turn it so that guide lug enters the camway of the bolt carrier. Insert tip of the piston into opening in the rear part of the rear sight base. Place bolt carrier into cutout section in receiver track and pressing down move it forward until it locks in forward position. Place recoil spring into opening on top part of bolt carrier, press it forward slightly and place rear bottom lug section into dovetail slot in the rear of the receiver. Place receiver cover on top and by pressing it down and forward snap it into place. Pull operating handle back, release it, pull the trigger. Push safety lever catch up and insert the magazine. Standard issue for automat Kalashnikova is 30 round capacity, staggered double row curved magazine made of steel or plastic. Rounds are loaded by inserting it into opening, pressing down and pushing the round towards the back wall of the magazine. Besides standard 30-round capacity magazines, there are curved 40-round magazines for 7.62 by 39 caliber AKs, 45-round magazines for 5.45 by 39 caliber weapons, a number of drum and box type magazines, most often used for RPK light machine guns. There are a number of accessories made for Kalashnikov automatic rifles. Besides variety of optical devices, two most common additions are under-barrel grenade launchers and bayonets. Bayonets for AK family of rifles are sturdy, multifunctional combat survival tools that can be used to perform multiple tasks. To attach a bayonet to Kalashnikov rifle, place the ring over flash suppressor or muzzle brake, and align dovetail slot located at the end of the handle with bayonet lock located below gas cylinder. Press the bayonet back until it snaps into place. To remove the bayonet, press release button on the handle and pull bayonet forward. aside from using bayonet as combat knife by itself or attached to an AK, or throwing knife, AK bayonet is designed to perform as wire cutter. Placing cutout on the bayonet blade over the lug at the front end of scabbard and turning bayonet body so that blade moves towards the tip of the scabbard, it cuts the wire placed in the cutout on the scabbard. Single shot under barrel grenade launchers GP25 or GP30 are great and powerful weapons designed to engage targets for up to 400 meters away. To attach grenade launcher, place it under the barrel with cutout slot aligned with bayonet lug of an AK. Press it back until it locks into place. While Kalashnikov weapons are and will remain for years to come predominant individual combat weapons in Russian armed forces, new truly revolutionary design, Avtomat Nikonova, designated as AN-94, is being gradually introduced into service. It is based on the same 5.45x39 cartridge as used by AK-74 family of weapons. With its revolutionary operating system, it will be setting new standard in the world of combat automatic rifles for a long time to come.
Combat movement can determine whether you live or die. Developing good movement skills with a firearm in combat conditions plays a crucial role in professional preparation. It is good to study and develop movement from perspective of keeping it natural and absent of unnecessary tension. Movement has to be energy efficient, quiet, and allow for immediate change in direction, mode, and speed.
Movement in combat environment should not be looked at as transition between stable stationary positions. While stationary positioning has its place in the realm of combat involving firearms, movement is primary to positioning. It is important not to allow your adversaries to pinpoint your location, remain mobile during engagements, and use movement in the most efficient manner to prevail or disengage. Movement could be used in any combination involving all planes of three-dimensional realm to change elevation, lateral shifting, or distance control. Developing solid and relaxed natural movement is especially crucial for close quarters work. Ability to use vertical displacement is one of the most important aspects in learning to move in the realm of armed close quarters combat. It can provide multiple benefits, lowering your profile, thus minimizing your opponent's ability to accurately engage you, giving you element of surprise in tactical sense, offering a relatively safer environment to conduct additional tasks, related or not to combat engagement. It also provides stable platform for aimed precision shooting. It is important to learn and practice the most efficient ways of immediate change of elevation without tensing up, losing ability to accurately engage adversaries, and unnecessarily stopping the movement on other planes of three-dimensional realm. The most important stages of vertical displacement are going from standing to kneeling or sitting and from standing to prone. To efficiently shift to kneeling from standing or moving, it is good to maintain your back straight, not allowing hips to shift backwards. Such shift can negatively affect your shooting platform if it happens during active shooting engagement. In standing or moving mode, walking, running, and so on, knees should remain slightly bent at all times, shoulders relaxed and aligned with hips. Depending on direction and mode of movement, specifics of environment, moving to kneeling level could be done with lead or back leg initiating the movement. Kneeling position, depending on circumstances, lends itself for movement that can provide 360-degree coverage with a firearm, especially if deploying ambidextrous approach to firearm handling. At any stage of this movement, it is easy to initiate yet another vertical displacement, up or down, in any direction. Another method of 360-degree movement is from sitting position. By moving hips over the bent leg and shifting weight in circular movement, this method is very useful in situations requiring ability of 360-degree work and constant movement. Going into a prone position doesn't have to be multiple stage movement. Going down on knees and hands and then continuing into prone. One of the ways to do it works from stationary or mobile base, regardless of direction of the movement and intended direction you have to face once in prone position. Start by moving either leg forward as if to take a step, but don't shift the body weight forward. Instead, start lowering body down, keeping back straight, hips tucked under, and moving towards the heel of support leg. You can add side roll towards the end of the movement, thus combining vertical and horizontal displacement in one movement. Rolling is one of the methods to change the position in all three dimensions in combat environment. Relaxed body, calm, regulated breathing tied to the movement are essential factors for rolling. Another important factor is preventing firearm from coming into hard contact with the surface, as to avoid possibility of malfunction or damage. It applies to front, back, and side rolls. One distinct moment for executing side rolls is use of legs as opposed to upper body to initiate a roll. This allows for more stable platform to continue engaging targets with the firearm. This factor should be considered in executing more conventional movements in all dimensions, changing elevation, lateral movement, and moving forwards or backwards. In three-dimensional realm of engagement with the firearms, horizontal plane in the relation to adversary is probably the most difficult to use, not only because of possible presence of obstacles, but due to some psychological factors. Most often the tendency is to lower the profile and stay there. While changing the elevation could and often is good course of action while in combat involving firearms, it should not be the first and only course of action. Training to deploy three-dimensional movement in numerous combat conditions is fundamental skill. Training should include element of multitasking, performing additional tasks, such as deploying ambidextrous weapon handling drills, changing magazines, bringing the weapon into various positions for engagement, and so on. Acquiring and developing these and many other skills while maintaining one's mobility is imperative for close quarters battle, especially in teamwork environment. One such training drill is developing ability to aim with the body movement as opposed to aiming by only moving weapon itself.
In general, there are two ways to aim. You aim with the weapon, or you aim with the body. Okay. There is no one absolutely right way to do it. You use it according to situation, according to circumstances you can be in. Okay. Generally speaking, aiming with your body, you will be more accurate. Sometimes, because of aiming with the body creates the whole body movement, and for the purposes of not being spotted, you don't want that much of a movement. You might want to aim just with the weapon without moving the whole body in such an angle. If I'm moving in this direction, by the virtue of me aiming with the weapon, okay, I create unnecessary tension in my body. I have a lot of tension in this foot, I have tension in my back, and I have unnatural tension in my shoulder. Now, depending on the caliber, the recoil will have negative effect on my accuracy if I deploy a weapon this way. You will be more efficient to aim with your body than to aim with your weapon. Because now again, I created a lot of unnecessary tension and my accuracy has been reduced.
Additionally, aiming with the body movement achieves several objectives at the same time: acquisition of hostile target while displacing self as a target on multiple dimensions. For combat proficiency, many other aspects should be studied and explored in depth. Methods of walking, whether pushing off with back leg or pulling with the front, specific ways of movement for various environments, stairs, ladders, potentially noisy surfaces, and even moving through areas that could possibly have presence of mines and booby traps, are all areas relevant to movement in combat conditions. Some of these areas will be discussed in future video releases. Transition from various conditions of weapon readiness to initiating combat engagement is one of the most crucial areas of preparation and training. Many factors being of equal importance, operator has to combine speed and timing of the action, efficiency of movement, bringing weapon to readiness condition while maintaining mobility and coverage. Because of specifics of AK design, few issues are unique to work with Kalashnikov automatic rifle.
If one has to change the magazine, put the fresh magazine in. Because of AK design, after you shoot out all the rounds from your previous magazine, the weapon does not stay in a locked back position like some of the other designs do. It fires the last round and it comes back into initial position. The fresh magazine in, okay, you have to charge the round in again to be able to fire the weapon. Okay. The method is using your support hand to do it.
Good way to practice this method is repeatedly release safety, lever catch, and work charging handle using support arm of your shooting platform.
You don't want your hand removed away from the trigger mechanism at any time, unless absolutely necessary to get rid of the weapon and deploy different means. Don't ever look at it and see what's going on here, okay? Whatever the position is, you might be low down, okay? Continue surveying. Do not continue surveying with your eyes. Your gun stays here, you see something there. If you're watching something, follow with the gun. Okay, you need to charge it. Don't ever look what you're doing with your arm. Because you might have
this method should become instinctive action in order for operator to be able to deploy the weapon in timely manner and without sacrificing movement, as dictated by the situation. Good initial way to learn this method is have person react to sound stimulus and using constant movement take efficient action to engage the potential threat. Adding operating the charging handle while in motion to engage and later change in movement mode starts building ability for multitasking in combat environment.
They turn towards the target, but they turn exactly at the spot where they were standing. They do not vacate the spot where they were a target to begin with. Vacate that spot. That's called multitasking, guys. And it's not easy. We all think we can do a lot of things in sequence. How many things you can do at the same time? That's what separates the soldier from specialist. Okay? Specialist has to be able to do a lot of things simultaneously.
Basic movement skills, relax the natural way of moving, correct posture play a major role in evolving ability to react in conditional drills, to free flowing, unrestricted and efficient movement and rapid deployment of the weapon under stress of combat in close quarters.
I want you, while you're going down, I'm walking, okay,
With number of possible carry positions, it is important to practice deploying your AK for combat engagement from these positions. From shoulder carry on the sling to higher combat readiness carry positions, all possibilities should be practiced and explored. One important method is called skidivanie in Russian, literally throwing off. This method is important because the movement principle transcends into much of the work with the firearms, as well as other aspects of close quarters combat. From holding your AK on the inside part of your bent arm, move it into combat readiness by pointing with that arm in the direction of intended use. Slightly rotate your forearm inward in wave-like motion. This movement could be incorporated into a number of training drills, combining reaction to stimulus, various methods of movement, development of multitasking abilities under stress conditions. As an extension into live fire training, it is good to start practicing firing your weapon immediately after deploying it into combat readiness, from different positions and platforms and while moving. This training should start from understanding importance of correct, relaxed, but solid posture and natural flowing movement. Some more advanced methods are discharging initial round one-handed and then proceeding to more conventional and reliable aimed firing. To develop ability of engaging adversaries while moving and do it with accuracy and speed, it is necessary to work on fundamental skills of proper firearm handling, efficient ways of dealing with recoil while continuing moving, and psychological conditioning to remain calmly determined and emotionally detached.
You can be very smooth and very flowing with your reaction. As a matter of fact, you will get on target, directly on target, if you are that way. If I was more like a jerky kind of guy, and I hear the sound there and I go, I'll overreact. I'll be off of that direction where the impulse came from by quite a bit. Okay? And actually timing will be much worse, as opposed to me just being very calm and it took exactly the same time, but I'm right on. Let's discuss in short order high ready and low ready carry positions of the weapon. Depending where do you do the work, in open environment, as in outside, or you work in urban situation, as in inside the buildings. Each of the methods, high ready and low ready, has its own purpose. Preferred method for immediate engagement would be high ready. Gravity is a natural occurrence. You can let the gravity work and place the weapon right on the target. The difference from letting the gravity do its job and being accurate instantly is, from low ready, there is usually an, so to speak, overkill. If I'm in low ready and I need to aim the weapon, I have to adjust, make a correction to my initial movement, because we have a tendency to go further, to do more than needs to be done. A high ready position would not be a preferred method of carry if one is on the mission of securing, clearing the building with possibility of non-combatants being on the upper floors. Up until the very moment of immediate engagement, one does not want to place his finger directly on the trigger. That's the carry way.
Trigger safety should be taken seriously even by seasoned operators. Startle effect, incredible amount of stress paired with the bad trigger discipline can result in tragic event. To lower your shooting position even further while in prone, whether for better concealment or for conducting fire engagement from under the vehicle, turn the weapon sideways and you can use charging handle as aiming device.
with a common sense to not aim with one eye closed. Having your eye closed eliminates your ability to see anything from here on to that side. Okay? You will not be able to react to any movement there if you have one eye completely closed. Again, it takes time and practice to be able to aim both eyes open. You can partially squint with that eye, yet you'll still be able to see any movement, any indication, and react to it accordingly.
Automat Kalashnikov lends itself for very effective use as a tool in hand-to-hand combat. Situations requiring such use of Kalashnikov automatic rifle, or for that matter almost any other shoulder-fired rifle, shotgun or submachine gun, can range from malfunction of the firearm while engaged in close-quarters combat, effectively dealing with non-cooperative, non-combatant in variety of situations, need for capturing adversary for interrogation. Also, operator may have to use his weapon in such manner when working in environment with highly flammable materials or sensitive explosives present, with equipment or devices that may hold valuable information in immediate proximity of engagement and number of other situations.
Kalashnikov in its design is very unique in the world of modern military firearms. More refined from a standpoint of user-friendliness, AK's many external design features are most useful in close-quarters work, specifically in hand-to-hand close-quarters environment. Its front sight post, angular and with numerous non-rounded edges, has many uses. Short impact, ripping and tearing motions, hooking and controlling approaches all find extensive use while engaged in hand-to-hand combat using AK as a tool. AK's curved magazine, in combination with its stock, pistol grip, barrel, or any part of operator's hands, is often used for leverage-based work in takedowns, extensions, locking and controlling, as well as for more defensive work against armed or unarmed attacks.
Using AK for leverage work, all parts of the weapon can be used in any combination. Controlling forearm with pistol grip and using magazine to create support on opponent's upper arm for easy takedowns, and using similar approach with use of the stock and pistol grip are simple but effective methods. In similar manner, AK can be used to hyperextend opponent's elbow for takedowns or breaks. Using curved magazine in combination with handguard allows for similar work in takedowns or effective locks. Adding impact or push approach using buttstock presents some additional solutions, as well as use of any part of operator's hand in creating leverage options. Leverage work can be used on multiple planes simultaneously, using all parts of opponent's body. With its sturdy design, able to withstand hard use in severe combat conditions, AK is well suited for hard contact or impact work in hand-to-hand environment. One of key principles, even when working with such formidable combat tool as Avtomat Kalashnikova against unarmed opponent, is escaping or vacating line of attack, thus avoiding any possible aggressive action and direct frontal contact. Any part of AK could be used as striking device, and the striking action should be natural extension of escaping, avoiding, redirecting movement. AK magazine serves as very formidable striking device. As does buttstock or any part of the barrel, including front sight post. Compensator or muzzle brake, as well as front sight post, are very effective not only in impact mode, but in hard contact control or takedown work. Confronting opponent armed with a knife, vacating line of attack is preferred approach, yet under some circumstances, AK can be used in more direct fashion, working opponent's limbs or body, for takedowns, locks, disarms, or in more disabling manner. Movement is extremely important when engaging multiple opponents, unarmed or armed. It should focus on avoiding direct contact and moving in such a way as to position adversaries in each other's path. If faced with an opponent armed with an AK or any other assault rifle, the most important issue is clearing the muzzle, that is, moving yourself out of the way from front of the barrel. This movement should be natural, relaxed, and it should not be overtly aggressive. Numerous options present itself as a result. Using legs to create obstacle while moving your opponent in the direction of that obstacle and closing in on your opponent to immobilize him and take away the possibility of him engaging you with a firearm. Whether working from the front or back, you can close in while moving firearm in safe for you direction and placing hard surface of the firearm against pain-sensitive or vulnerable areas of opponent's body, and taking variety of measures, striking, pain compliance, and so on, to end the situation. Because of placement of magazine release catch on AK weapons, it is possible to remove the magazine while moving out of the way of the firearm and use it for disarming or takedowns. If using knife in work against opponent with an AK, it is possible to use front sight post of AK to initiate movement forward while stepping aside to clear the muzzle. Use created forward movement to engage vulnerable areas of adversary's body. Deploying all means besides the weapon can maximize chances of quick and positive ending. You can also use space between the gas tube and the barrel of an AK to insert the blade and disarm your opponent. In using AK against attacker who is also armed with a rifle, use of leverages, relaxed and solid posture and movement are keys to taking full advantage of all possibilities.
Yeah, that hand doesn't want to be there anymore. Just to strike his fingers here. Nice ring, by the way. Thank you. You hook the arm, natural leverage works as such.
Initially, majority of training should be done at relatively slow speed for a number of reasons. AK, as most other firearms, by virtue of extensive use of metal and hard plastic, with some parts of the weapon having sharp edges, when used at higher speed and without having developed good, efficient mechanics and control of movement, can cause damage and serious injury. Slower speed training develops proper understanding of many things involved in complex realm of combat, thus resulting in calmer and emotionally detached way of functioning in real-life combat situations. In time, such training methodology develops different mentality in practitioner, accepting reality of confrontation in almost casual fashion, without fear and its byproduct, hyperaggression, clouding sound judgment and disrupting ability to see total picture of the situation in combat environment. At the high level of proficiency, work with AK flows from soft to hard approaches, seamlessly adapting to changing situation, as could be seen in a short demonstration by Vladimir Vasilyev. Unmatched reliability of automat Kalashnikova is well known. This short segment demonstrates some of the tests that AK was subjected to assure its ability to withstand severe conditions of combat and be able to function.
5.45 by 39 round used by AK-74, and number of modifications and models is significant improvement over 5.56 by 45 NATO round used by M16, M4, AR-15 family of weapons and many other Western designs. In large part, improvement is due to the 5mm air pocket in the tip of the bullet. This pushes the center of gravity back, and while making for very aerodynamic, thin bullet, nearly full inch in length, with excellent ballistic characteristics, it causes the bullet to yaw very quickly on impact, much quicker than 223 or 7.62 by 39. In addition, the core slides asymmetrically into air pocket, causing a unpredictable change in bullet's path. This very quick yaw on impact increases the speed of very significant energy dump and damage, especially on peripheral hits.
Rounds of both calibers for AK can also be used as a weapon for silent war, sentry takeout, or as effective and damaging impact tool in hand-to-hand combat.
This is a wire cutter, right? You know, in politically incorrect situation where I have to ask some questions, you know, this is not a wire that's going to be in there, okay? If I really have to ask some tough questions about life, it's going to be his nostrils. Okay, that's few of the politically incorrect ways of using the tool.
Sling can also be used for a variety of purposes. One of them is using sling as a support device for a weapon, useful in situations where one has to hold a firearm for a long time in readiness position for precision shot.